Okay, here we are.
Dobrodošli.
Today we will have a very good word.
Danas ćemo imati dobru propoved.
You know, God is blessing us with his presence.
Bog nas blagoslovio njegovim prisustvom.
You know, we want to be humble.
Mi želimo da budemo ponosni.
And that we are humble. Da ne budemo ponosni.
Da budemo ponizni, pardon.
Yeah. And that God can speak to us.
Da Bog može da nam govori.
And he does.
I on nam govori.
Right. And today we will speak some very good things.
Ja, govorit ćemo jako dobre stvari danas.
Maybe it will be as good as the worship.
Možda će biti dobro
kao što je bilo slavljenje. The ukulele, the singing, the beat, you know. Wow.
Ukulele.
Maybe we could make a concert.
Možda napravite koncert.
We can go on a Kalemegdan and do a concert.
Možemo otići na Kalemegdan i da napravimo mali koncert.
That would be amazing. You know, why not?
Što da ne?
And if it goes bad, people will come and they will help us.
Ako bude
loše. A lot of musicians there, you know.
Ljudi će doći i pomoći će.
They will come and they will say, hey, you, shh. Please.
Molim te, tiše malo.
Let them sing.
I pustimo njih da peve.
That's okay. So we could do it.
Možemo to da
uradimo. What do you think?
Šta vi mislite?
We could do concert on the street.
Koncert na ulici.
Yeah. Why not?
Zašto da ne?
So, dear Jesus.
Dragi Isuse, molimo ti se.
Thank you.
Hvala ti.
We thank you, really, for who you are.
Hvala ti zbog toga ko si ti.
And for what you do in our lives.
I šta radiš u našim životima.
And we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Zahvaljujemo ti se i molimo se u Isusu.
Amen.
Amen.
So, I have this very good teaching here.
Imam jako dobro učenje danas.
And you know, you come here to this church.
Došli ste danas u crkvu.
And you think.
I mislite.
You know, is it perfect church?
Da li je ovo savršena crkva?
Or it's not perfect church?
Ili nesavršena.
And now you like, oh, there's no perfect church on earth.
Ne postoji savršena crkva.
You know, that's how people think.
Tako ljudi razmišljaju.
And you will hear preachers saying there is no perfect church on earth.
I čućete propovednike koji govore nema ni jedne savršene crkve.
And I know what they mean a little bit, you know.
I ja razumem šta oni govore.
But I'll tell you something different.
Ali reći ću vam nešto drugačije.
This is a perfect church.
Ovo je savršena crkva.
You know why?
Znate zašto?
Matthew 16:18 Jesus says, I will build my church.
U Mateju 16:18 Isus kaže, ja ću se graditi moju crkvu.
Jesus is doing this.
Isus radi ovo.
This is a work of God.
Ovo je delo Božje.
And listen, work of God is perfect.
I slušajte, Božje delo je savršeno.
This is perfect church.
Ovo je savršeno.
And I don't speak about the details.
Ne govorimo o detaljima.
I don't speak about the missing toilet paper at the bathroom, you know.
Ne govorim što nedostaje toilet papir u toaletu.
There's a many stories when people miss toilet paper in the bathroom, but but we are, this is the perfect church.
Ima puno takvih priča, ali ovo je savršena crkva.
Even if the paper is missing there.
Čak i ako nema toilet papira.
Maybe you are there and you are the one who finds out and it's too late.
Možda ste tamo i saznate i onda je kasno.
And you think this is a horrible church.
I misliš ovo je užasna crkva.
You know what? This is perfect church.
Znate šta,
this is the work of God.
Savršena crkva je ovo Božje delo.
And maybe me by sitting there I learn something.
I možda zato što sedim samo tu naučit ću nešto.
I learned that God's work is perfect even though I don't like it.
Naučit ću da je Božje delo savršeno čak i ako mi se ne sviđa.
Maybe I will learn patience.
Možda ću naučiti se strpljenju.
Now you have to wait that somebody will find you there and help you.
Sad treba da sačekate da neko dođe da vam pomogne.
Now I have to learn to control my anger.
Treba da naučim da kontrolišem svoj bes.
How come nobody put here the paper? Who's doing it?
Kako niko nije
stavio papir? Who is on the list?
Papir.
Let's talk to them.
Hajde da razgovaramo sa njima.
Maybe I learn forgiveness.
Možda ću naučiti da oprostim.
And maybe I will even learn my place in the church.
Možda ću naučiti koje je moje mesto u crkvi.
Hey, maybe I could bring a paper.
E možda ja mogu da donesem
papir. And I learn how to be used in the church.
I naučim kako mogu da budem iskorišćen u crkvi.
By the way, when we read the 1 Corinthians 12, 13 and 14, these chapters.
Kada čitamo 1. Korinćanima 12, 13 i 14.
You know, we learn that the gifts are for the church.
Mi učimo da su darovi za crkvu.
You know, everybody is gifted.
Svako ima dar.
And some are very much gifted.
I neki su mnogo daroviti.
You know, and it's been given to us.
I dano je nama.
Not for us.
Ne za nas same.
You know, but for the church.
Već za crkvu.
For the service.
Za službu.
That's amazing.
I to je divno.
You know. Funny thing is when people come.
Smiješne stvari su kad
you know,
ljudi dođu.
And they say, "Well, God."
I kažu, "Bože."
You know, I think.
Ja mislim.
If you do it a little bit differently.
Ako bi uradio malo drugačije.
Then you know the church would grow and we would have more people.
Onda bi crkva porasla i bilo bi više ljudi.
You know, maybe if there would be less Bible and more singing.
Ako bi bilo manje Biblije i više pevanja.
Or if there would be no leader.
Ili ako nema nijednog ko vodi.
You know, let's just make a Bible club and everybody will be saying his own opinions.
Hajde da napravimo biblijski klub i da svako daje svoje mišljenje.
That's what people like.
To je ono što
Jesus.
Isus.
You know? No, we do it the way God wants to do it.
Ne, mi želimo da radimo onako kako Bog želi.
Because he says, I will build my church, he says.
Zato što je on rekao, ja ću sagraditi moju crkvu.
And his work is perfect.
A njegovo delo je savršeno.
He established certain things in the Bible certain way for a purpose.
On je namerio određene stvari koje pišu u Bibliji da budu tu sa smislom.
And maybe we don't like it.
I možda nam se ne dopada.
But God is working in our heart.
Ali Bog radi u našem srcu.
You know how many things I did not like when I came to church the first time?
Znate koliko mi se stvari nije dopalo kada sam prvi put došao.
And the church, I mean gathering, not the building.
I kad kažem crkvu, mislim na okupljanje, ne na zgradu.
I didn't like this person.
Nije mi se svidala ova osoba.
I didn't like that person.
Ni onu osobu nisam.
I didn't like the person who preaches.
Ni osoba koja propovijeda.
I didn't like nobody.
Nikoga nisam.
I thought the perfect church is when I'm there only.
Mislio sam da je savršena crkva samo kad sam ja tu.
Me and Jesus.
Ja i Isus.
That's what some people think.
Tako neki ljudi misle.
That's why they stay home and they watch the YouTube.
Zato ostaju kući i gledaju YouTube.
Right? Because they are bothered by other people.
Jel su
they give them troubles other people.
Da, drugi ljudi im donose problem.
But that's the time for love.
Ali to je vreme kad možemo da pokažemo ljubav.
You know when you read the Song of Solomon, the time for love.
Kada čitamo pesmu nad pesmama, vreme za ljubav.
It's a time to love somebody.
To je vreme da voliš nekoga.
Wow. Because if we would come into perfect church,
jer ako bi došli u neku savršenu crkvu,
there, how could I be used?
Kako mogu da budem iskorišćen?
You know, chairs are in a perfect line.
Stolice su u savršenoj liniji.
You know, all the songs are on the screen.
Sve pesme su na.
There's no need for me to type it in.
Na TV-u ne mora ništa da se
ukuca. Everything is perfect.
Sve je savršeno.
Everybody is happy.
Svi su.
Nobody is in troubles.
Niko nije u problemima.
Yeah. You know, or you come to church, which is normal church.
Ili dođeš u crkvu koja je normalna.
And now maybe you can encourage somebody who is hurting.
I možda možeš sada da ohrabriš nekog ko je.
You can say, how is it at home?
U nekoj boli. Kako
how is it going?
Kako ide?
Are you hungry?
Jesi li gladan?
You know, we can buy you food.
Možemo da kupimo hranu.
You know, or we can just talk to you.
Ili samo razgovaraš.
We can pray with you.
Možemo da se molimo.
We can change things by prayer.
Mi možemo da promenimo stvari molitvom.
Right, we've heard it last time.
Mi smo čuli to poslednji put.
When we heard about the horses in the mountains.
Kad smo pričali o konju koji je došao u planinu.
And the beaver's tail, you remember?
I dabrov rep, da se sećate.
It's like we can change things by prayer.
Mi možemo da promenimo stvari molitvom.
It's amazing.
I to je divno.
If everything is fine, we don't need to pray.
Ako je sve super, ne moramo ni da se molimo.
Yeah. So perfect church.
Dakle, savršena crkva.
Doesn't mean it's perfect in every detail.
Ne znači da je savršena u svakom detalju.
But it means that I recognize it's a work of God.
Nego treba da prepoznamo da je to Božje delo.
Because the church is perfect with all its flaws and mistakes.
Jer crkva je savršena sa svim svojim manama i greškama.
It's like your wife.
To je kao vaša žena.
She is perfect.
Ona je savršena.
With all its flaws and mistakes.
Sa svim manama i
right?
greškama.
Because it's a mindset.
Jer to je pogled.
She is a gift.
Ona je dar.
She's a gift from God.
Ona je dar od Boga.
You know, with all its flaws and mistakes.
Sa svim manama i greškama.
And then I am there to love her.
Ja sam tu da je volim.
And help her and lead her
i vodim.
And pray for her.
I molim se za nju.
And encourage her.
I ohrabrim.
And of course, if you are a husband and to say that you are sorry.
I ako si supru kažeš izvini.
Yeah, you that's what you learn in the marriage.
To se nauči u braku.
You know, you learn to say you are sorry.
Naučiš da kažeš izvini.
And it's amazing even in the church.
To je divno čak i u crkvi.
You know, we can learn to say I'm sorry.
Možemo da naučimo da kažemo izvini.
Because you will see many things today.
Jer ćete vidjeti mnogo stvari danas.
You know, somebody said
neko je rekao
something about our church.
Nešto o našoj crkvi.
And they said, I don't like this church.
I rekli su, ne sviđa mi se ova crkva.
Because they are bringing gypsies there.
Jer dovode Rome tu.
You remember how we rejoiced when we had this like gathering with the gypsies at the New Year Eve?
Da li se sećate koliko smo radosni bili kad su oni došli ovde za Novu godinu?
And yet there is somebody who said, I don't like it because they have gypsies there.
A ima ljudi koji kažu, ne sviđa mi se crkva jer ima tamo Roma.
You see, maybe the gypsies are here because of you.
Možda su Romi tu baš zbog vas.
That you would learn something.
Da bi naučili nešto.
That you would learn to love the unloved.
Da naučite da volite one koji nisu voljeni.
That we would learn to walk by faith, not by sight.
Naučite da hodate verom, ne gledanjem.
That's amazing.
To je neverovatno.
And the person was bothered by it.
I ta osoba je bila pogođena tim.
Isn't it fascinating?
Zar nije to fascinantno?
There was one woman which came to me once.
Jedna dama je došla kod mene.
And she said, I don't like this man in your church.
Ne volim ovog, ne sviđa mi se ovaj čovjek u crkvi.
You should tell him not to come to this church.
Treba da mu kažeš da ne dolazi u crkvu.
What? Can you believe it?
Šta?
Can you believe what I'm dealing with?
Da, možete da
what the people tell me?
Šta ja čujem od ljudi?
You know what? I'm happy that the man is coming.
Ja sam srećen što taj čovjek dolazi.
And you know what? It's amazing he comes.
I divno je što on dolazi.
You know, and is he perfect?
Da li je on savršen?
No, he is a part of the perfect work of God.
Ne, on je deo savršenog Božjeg dela.
Because neither am I perfect. And neither are you.
Nisam ni ja savršen, čak ni ti.
This is amazing.
To je divno kad
svatim. You know, the church is not for those who are already perfect.
Crkva nije za one koji su već savršeni.
No, the church is for us.
Crkva je za nas.
It's a hospital.
To je bolnica.
And we can learn many things.
Možemo da naučimo mnoge stvari.
Patience.
Strpljenje.
You know, it's a big thing in nowadays world.
To je velika stvar za današnji svet.
You know, people don't have a patience.
Ljudi danas nemaju strpljenje.
And if you say, how do you know?
I ako kažeš kako znaš to?
Go on a bus stop.
Idite
and you will hear.
Na autobusku you know, stanicu.
They are watching the minutes, you know. And,
ne gledaju minute.
You know, we were watching the minutes, like recently at the bus stop.
Nismo gledali za koliko će da dođe.
It was showing 20 minutes.
Piše 20 minuta.
Then bus was coming in 6 minutes.
Zatim bus za 6 minuta.
Then in 20 minutes again.
Zatim it was like 20.
You know, the instructions were lying to us.
Da, display nas je lagao.
And hey, you know, we learned patience.
A mi smo naučili strpljenje.
You know, waiting for God.
Čekanje na Boga.
Waiting for the promise.
Čekanje obećanja.
Not being like Abraham and fulfilling the promise in his flesh.
Ne kao Avram što je ispunio obećanje po telu.
Now, if you read the first and second Corinthians ever,
ako ste ikad čitali prvo i drugo Korinćanima,
and we will turn there now,
Sada ćemo krenuti tamo.
And we are teaching First and Second Corinthians in the Bible school actually.
I u biblijskoj školi smo prošli kroz prvu Korinćanima, sada smo u drugoj.
And these are like amazing books.
I to su neverovatne poslanice.
I used to say, imagine you would be in a Corinth in this church.
Ja sam govorio uvek, zamislite da ste u Korintu u ovoj crkvi.
You know, the chaos.
U tom haosu.
You know, they are not recognizing the authority of Paul in the 1 Corinthians 1, 12, 13, 14, and so on.
Oni ne prepoznaju Pavlov autoritet u 1. Korinćanima 1, 12, pa do kraja.
You know, in 2 Corinthians 1, 13, Paul says, you acknowledge me in part.
U 1. Korinćanima 1, 13, Pavle kaže, prihvatate me u... Samo da pročitam.
2 Corinthians 1:13 and 14.
2 Corinthians. Druga Korinćanima 1:13. Poznajte me.
Yeah, you I write no other things but you read or acknowledge, and I trust you shall acknowledge even to the end.
Jer vam drugo ne pišemo nego što čitate i razumete, a nadam se da ćete i do kraja razumeti.
He says, I'm not bringing anything new, you know. Kažem, and then verse 14, as also you have acknowledged us in part.
I onda u 14. stiku, kao što neki i razume, kao što ste i neki razumeli.
Yeah, neki, yeah, some of you.
Neki od vas,
yeah. Some of you, so imagine maybe half of the church was for Paul, they understood that he's not bringing anything new.
Zamislite da je pola crkve prepoznalo Pavla i njegov autoritet i da nije ništa novo.
And the other half of the church were like suspicious.
Druga polovina je sumnjala.
What's this grace teaching?
Šta je ovo učenje o milosti?
What is Paul teaching?
Šta ovo Pavle uči?
Who do you think he is? He received this revelation of grace.
Šta mislite, ko je on? On je dobio otkrivenje milosti.
That's what they were attacking him for.
Za to su ga napadali.
You know, in the 1 Corinthians 1, and we can start here, 11.
1 Corinthians 11.
It's been declared unto me, 1:11, my brethren, by them which are of the house of Chloe, that there are contentions among you.
1. Korinćanima 1:11. Jer sam čuo za vas, braćo moje, od Chloinih domaćih, da su svađe među vama.
And in the previous verse 10, he says that there be no divisions. The church was divided.
U 10. stiku on kaže da ne budu među vama rasprave.
And then verse 12, some of you say, I am of Paul, I am of Apollos, I am of Cephas, and I am of Christ.
12. stih kaže, neki kažu, ja sam Pavlo, ja sam Apolo, treći Kifine, četvrti, ja sam Hristo.
Imagine Paul would come to the church.
Zamislite Pavla da dolazi u tu crkvu.
And half of the church would start to clap, oh, Apostle Paul,
I pola crkve se raduje što je Pavle došao.
And the other half would be like, who is here? That's a strange teaching.
I pola, druga polovina crkve govori, ua, kako je ovo učenje.
And somebody would stand up, you know, with his group, and they would say, we listen Apollos only, not you, Paul.
I zamislite, jedan ustane iz te druge polovine i kaže, mi slušamo samo Apollo.
And some people would say, no, we listen Cephas, not Apollos, not Paul, not his new teaching.
Drugi ustani kaže, ne slušamo ni Apolosa, ni Pavla, nego Petra.
And some would say, no, we listen Christ only, you are all wrong, no authority.
A treći ustani kaže, ne slušamo nikoga, samo Hrista, ne treba nam nikakav autoritet.
I mean, what a chaos in the church.
Zamislite haos.
That's why he later on says, when one speak,
zato je posle on rekao, prophet, kada no. jedan govori ili prorokuje,
let all keep quiet.
Neka svi ostali ćute.
Because I can imagine they were just raising up and shouting at the Paul or the preachers and saying, no, we don't believe it.
Ja mogu da zamislim da su oni ustajali tada u crkvi kada je neko govorio i ukoravali i drali se u crkvi.
You know, and I say, I wouldn't want to be in this church.
I Pavle rekao, ne bih teo
I say, I wouldn't want to be in this church.
Ja kažem, ne bih volio da budem u takvoj crkvi.
But wait a minute.
Ali čekaj sekundu.
Maybe that would be amazing.
Možda bi to bilo divno.
There is a space for loving.
Tu je mesto da se pokaže ljubav.
Now I can forgive.
Sada mogu da oprostim.
Now I can lead my brother who is weaker in faith.
Sada mogu da vodim svog brata koji je slab u veri.
You remember how he teaches about the meat sacrifice to idols?
Možda ste čitali
1 Corinthians, I think 8.
Ovde je on govorio o braći koje su jela meso žrtvovano idolima.
So they were still believing in the law.
Oni su i dalje verovali u neki zakon.
So you have a part of the church who are like legalists.
Imate pola crkve koji su legalisti.
And you can love them and teach them.
I možemo da ih volimo, da im pokažemo.
And now you see how Paul is dealing with the situation.
I sad vidimo kako Pavle rešava problem u crkvi.
You know, by sight it's a horrible church.
Ako gledamo samo na pogled sa spolja, to je užasna crkva.
Somebody would come and they would say, it's a horrible church.
Neko bi došao i rekao, ovo je užasna crkva.
And God says, it's my church.
I Bog kaže, to je moja crkva.
And it's a perfect work of God.
I to je savršeno Božje delo.
And they are not perfect in their behavior.
I nisu savršeni u svom ponašanju.
But I am teaching them.
Ali ih ja učim.
Through the Apostle Paul.
Kroz apostola
Pavla. Who started this church.
Koji je započeo crkvu.
And they don't even like him.
Ne vole.
You know, they are rejecting Apostle Paul.
Oni su odbili apostola Pavla.
And he addresses them very interestingly in 1 Corinthians 4:8.
I on im odgovara veoma interesantno u 1 Korinćanima 4:8.
He says, oh, now you are full. Now you are rich and you have reigned as kings without us.
Eto ste siti, eto se obogati ste, bez nas carujete.
Eto ste siti, eto ste bogati, bez nas carujete. Wow, what a proud church it was.
Kakva ponosita crkva je bila.
Here's Apostle Paul.
Ovde je apostol Pavle.
And one of the apostles who saw Jesus risen.
Jedan od apostola koji je video Isusa vaskrslo.
You know, and they do not recognize him.
I oni ga ne prepoznaju.
They don't want to listen to him.
Ne žele da ga slušaju.
And he says, and I wish before God that you would really reign.
I on kaže, o, da biste carovali.
But that we might also reign with you.
Da bismo i mi s vama carovali.
You know, and then he says, and I think that God has set us as apostles the last. We are appointed for death.
I u devetom stihu kaže, jer mislim da Bog nas apostole najstražnije postavi kao one koji su na smrt.
And verse 10.
I deseti stih.
Now there is a church which has its own opinion.
Postoji crkva koja ima svoje mišljenje.
You know, and he tells them in verse 10.
I oni kažu u desetom stihu.
We are fools for Christ's sake.
Mi smo budale.
But you are wise in Christ.
A vi ste mudri u
Hristu. You know, it's a nice sarcasm.
To je pravi sarkazam.
Oh, you are such a beautiful church.
Ovo ste tako divni.
You know, one is listening. Apollos, one Paul, one Christ.
Jedan sluša Apolosa, jedan Pavla, jedan Kifu, jedan Hrista.
Half of the church does not recognize the Paul's grace teaching and they say it's something new.
Pola crkve ne prepoznaje to učenje o milosti od Pavla i kaže to je nešto novo.
Some members live in adultery. In 1 Corinthians 5.
U 1. Korinćanima 5 neki žive u preljubi.
Then he teaches them about sexual purity, 1 Corinthians, you know, 7
zatim
and 6.
Zatim ih uči o čistoti, čednosti u 1. Korinćanima 6 i 7.
Then we said 1 Corinthians 8, they didn't want to eat meat sacrificed to idols.
Onda smo rekli, nisu hteli da jedu meso žrtvovano idolima.
You know, because they were legalists.
Jer su bili zakonici.
And he's teaching them, it's not about the calendar and the meats.
I on ih uči da nije o kalendarima, praznicima.
And he says there, the meat does not command us closer to God.
I on kaže,
does not bring us closer to God.
Da nas meso i hrana ne približava bliže Bogu.
You know, like, what are you focused on?
Na šta ste fokusirani?
And this is perfect church.
A to je savršena crkva.
Because there is a space for God's work.
Jer je tu mesto da Bog može da radi.
God's love.
Da Bog pokaže svoju ljubav.
Toward me.
Prema meni.
But also toward others.
Prema drugima isto.
Maybe I can love those who are not as perfect as I am.
Možda mogu da volim one koji nisu savršeni kao ja.
You know, and then he is teaching this amazing.
I onda ovo učenje koje deli sa njima.
1 Corinthians 1:23, we are still in the introduction to this church.
1 Corinthians 1:23.
He says, but we preach Christ crucified.
A mi propovedamo Hrista razapet.
You know, the context is that this church,
kontekst je ovde da je ova crkva
is not really receiving Paul.
Ne prihvata Pavla zaista.
He says, but we preach Christ.
On kaže, mi propovedamo.
You know, that's why he says 22, Jews require a sign, the Greeks seek after wisdom, but we preach Christ.
22. Stihu kaže, jer Jevreji znake ištu i Grci premudrosti traže.
And you know what it is to preach Christ?
A mi propovedamo Hrista.
The cross.
To je krst.
The death.
Smrt.
The redemption.
Otkupljenje.
This is what he is preaching.
To je ono što on
he is preaching propoveda. The redemption.
On propoveda otkupljenje.
You know, it's not about, church is not about perfect people.
Crkva nije o savršenim ljudima.
But it's about perfect redemption.
Već o savršenom otkupljenju.
He says, this is the mindset.
On kaže, to je način razmišljanja.
To redeem your brother.
Da otkupiš svog
brata. Not to condemn him.
Ne da ga osudiš.
It's so easy to come to church and say, hey, you are so wrong.
I jako je lako doći u crkvu i reći, ja, tako si krivo.
Or to lay down your life.
Ili da položiš svoj život.
And forgive.
I oprostiš.
Maybe he will say something to you.
Možda će reći nešto nazad.
Forgive.
Oprosti.
You preach the cross.
Ti propovedaš krst.
Not just with the words, but also with your life.
Ne samo rečima, nego i svojim životom.
That's amazing.
I to je divno.
That's how Paul is addressing this church. That's why he speaks about it.
Tako on uče ovu crkvu i tako govori njima.
You know, there is a chaos and anarchy.
Tu je haos i anarhija.
You know, no authority.
Nema autoriteta.
And he says, I bring the cross.
Ali ja donosim krst.
Laying down your life and redeeming the situation.
Položim svoj život i želim da otkupim ovu situaciju.
And the condemnation?
A osuda?
Jesus took upon himself.
Isus je uzeo na sebe.
When we are preaching the cross,
kad mi propovedamo krst,
you know, we lift up Jesus.
Mi podižemo Isusa.
And also in relationships, we take the blame.
I isto u odnosima mi možemo da preuzmemo krivicu.
Because we want to bring redemption.
Mi želimo da donesemo iskupljenje.
You know, I always thought that the perfect church is like I will have my place.
Ja sam uvijek mislio da je savršena crkva da je ću ja imati svoje mesto.
Nice air conditioning in summer.
Lepu klimu,
leti. You know, better than outside.
Bolje nego napolje.
You know, Starbucks coffee, you know.
Starbucks kafe.
You know, cheesecake after the message.
Cheesecake posle propovedi.
You know, people nicely dressed.
Ljudi lepo obučeni.
Nice smelly, you know.
Svila
beautiful kumiš. Perfumes,
savršeni
expensive watches,
skupi satovi.
Maybe you come to church and it's a mess and chaos.
A možda dođeš u crkvu i to je haos.
And maybe even you say in your heart, well, pastor, I wish this person is not coming.
I možda ti kažeš, želeo bi da ova druga osoba ne dolazi.
Well, maybe somebody says the same about you.
Možda neko drugi isto govori tako o tebi.
Yeah. But there is a time to love.
Ali tu je vreme da pokažemo ljubav i da otkupimo
and serve.
I da služimo.
And you know what? I can't thank you enough.
Ja ne mogu vama dovoljno da
and zahvalim. I can't thank God enough.
I ne mogu dovoljno Bogu da zahvalim.
That I see how you are redeeming.
Da vidim kako otkupljujete.
The situations and the people.
Situacije i ljude.
You know, you are so beautiful.
Vi ste divni.
You know, because you love everybody.
Jer volite sve.
You know, and you are serving.
I vi služite.
And you have ministry in the church.
I imate službu u crkvi.
With the word.
Sa reči.
With the encouragement.
Sa ohrabrenjem.
You know, in the fellowship.
U zajedništvu.
You know, in the practical things.
U praktičnim stvarima.
This is so amazing.
To je nevjerovatno.
And we learn also one more thing in the church.
Učimo još jednu stvar.
1 Corinthians 4:15.
1 Corinthians 4:15.
Let me see. Just a second. Sorry, 4:15. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 15.
1 Corinthians 4:15.
Paul says, for though you have 10,000 instructors in Christ,
jer ako imate i 300 učitelja u Hristu.
300?
Da, ovdje piše 300.
10,000? Oh, we have to look up the Greek.
Ovdje piše 300. Ako imate 10,000 učitelja u Hristu,
you have not many fathers.
Ali nemate mnogo otaca.
You know, the principle of a spiritual father.
Šta je princip duhovnog oca?
And we mentioned that discipleship,
i pomenuli smo to, to je sledbeništvo,
or a teacher and student,
ili taj odnos između
is always relational.
Učitelja i učenika je uvijek odnos.
You cannot learn from the books.
Ne možete da naučite iz knjiga samo.
You learn, you know, some intellectual knowledge.
Imate znanje, ste nakupili ste znanje.
But that's nothing.
Ali to je ništa.
Because you know what's learning.
Znate šta je učenje.
You are in the church.
Vi ste u crkvi.
You are in this mess.
Vi ste u tom haosu.
And you see how Paul is dealing with adultery in the church.
I vi vidite kako se Pavle rešava problem preljube u crkvi.
1 Corinthians 2, he is 1 Corinthians 5, he's very strong with the adultery.
1 Corinthians 5, on je vrlo jak prema preljubu.
2 Corinthians 2.
2 Corinthians 2.
He is so gracious.
On je tako milostiv.
Toward the sinner who was in adultery.
Prema grešniku koji je bio u preljubu.
And you are just like learning from Paul how he handles the situation.
I ti učiš od Pavla kako on rešava situaciju.
You know what the artery is, the big vein.
Znate šta je arterija?
You know, when you have an artery bleeding.
Kada arterija krvari.
Imagine somebody comes here and he's like stabbed and he has like bleeding arteries.
Zamislite da neko je uboden i da krvari.
It goes like this. Psst.
Ono.
Psst. Psst.
Prska. Izlazi.
You know? It's a pretty messy.
To je užasno.
And you know what you do?
Znate šta vi radite?
You just jump on him and you save him.
Iskočiš na njega i spasiš ga.
And you are all dirty and the room is dirty.
Sad se prljavi.
You know? We've been to emergency room in hospital recently.
Bili smo skoro u urgentnom.
And we've seen how they were bringing different like injuries there.
Videli smo kako dovode drugačije različite povrede.
Yeah, and the doctors are just doing this and this and this.
I ljudi doktori rade sa jednim i drugim.
That's not the book.
To nije knjiga.
That's life.
To je život.
And it's the church.
To je crkva.
You know, you cannot just read it, you have to live it.
Ne možeš samo da pročitaš, treba da živiš.
You know, not the medical book, but emergency room class.
Ne samo medicinska neka knjiga, nego...
You know, we cannot criticize that somebody is bleeding.
Ne možemo da kritikujemo nekoga ko krvari.
But we can come and save him.
Nego možemo da dođemo da ga spasimo.
You see the difference.
Vidite razliku.
And you know, yet there are churches which are so pure.
A opet postoje neke crkve koje su tako čiste.
But thank God we are not.
Hvala Bogu da mi nismo u tom smislu tako.
We are pure in holiness.
Mi smo čisti u svetosti.
We are pure in love.
Mi smo čisti u ljubavi.
You know, maybe we are messy that somebody is bleeding.
Možda neko ovde, možda smo tako u nekom haosu, neko krvari.
And you know, when somebody is hurting, you know what he's doing?
I kad je neko povređen, znate šta on radi?
What do you do when you are hurting?
Šta ti radiš?
You're screaming!
Ti vrištiš.
You know, maybe somebody is screaming in the church because he's hurting.
Možda neko vrišti u crkvi ili povrijedi.
Oh, you know what, this behavior is not acceptable in our church and we would like to ask you, for the love of God, please leave.
Ovo ponašanje nije dozvoljeno u crkvi, mi te molimo u ljubavi Božjoj da napustiš.
Or maybe we can drag him in and say, hey, what's wrong, do you need help? Wake up, you know, what do you need?
Ili možemo da ga unesemo u crkvu i kažemo šta treba.
And you are doing this.
I mi radimo to.
You are not afraid of the muddy work.
Vi niste uplašeni tog prljavog posla.
Yeah, this is so great.
I to je tako divno.
When we understand what's the perfect church.
Kada razumemo šta je savršena crkva.
You know, perfect church is a loving church.
Savršena crkva je ona koja voli.
You remember how we were speaking about the churches in the book of Revelation?
Sećate kako smo govorili o crkvama u Otkrivenju?
This one thing I have against you.
O jednu stvar.
That you have left your first love.
Da si napustio svoju prvu ljubav.
You know, but now love is here.
Al ne, ljubav je ovdje.
Now, love looks beyond these things.
I ljubav gleda
preko tih stvari.
Yeah, because we love the person and we receive the love from God.
Jer mi volimo tu osobu i primamo Božju ljubav.
And it reminds me there is some movie I didn't see it yet.
I to me podsjeća, ima jedan film koji nisam još pogledao.
And it's like about the traditional church.
I govori se o tradicionalnoj crkvi.
And it's in the 60s, the hippies movement.
To je u 60-im godinama, onaj hippie pokret.
You know, and there is a guy who's preaching to his like little church in New York.
I to je pastor koji propovjeda svoje maloj crkvi.
And then these hippies come into his church.
I onda ti hippie ulaze u njegovu crkvu.
Man with the long hair.
Čovjek sa dugom kosom.
Yeah. Doesn't the Bible teach us it's a shame if a man has a long hair?
Zar Biblija ne uči da čovjek treba da ne treba da ima dugu kosu?
And they come barefoot.
I oni dolaze bosi.
They don't have shoes.
Nemaju cipele.
You know, it's like, what are you going to do now?
Šta ćeš sad da uradiš?
Yeah. This is chaos.
To je haos za njih.
It shouldn't be in a church.
Oni ne treba ni da budu u crkvi.
Or there is a time for love.
Ili je tu vreme za ljubav.
And growth.
I rast.
And you know, washing the person.
I očistiti osobu.
You know, that's why he speaks about the person of weak faith.
Zato Pavle govori ovde sa osobama sa slabom verom.
You know, and he doesn't speak like I don't have a big faith.
I ne govori kao o veličini vere.
But 1 Corinthians 8 he speaks about the people of a weak faith not having the right faith.
Govori o tim ljudima koji nemaju pravo razumevanje šta je vera.
1 Corinthians 8:7. Their conscience being weak is defiled because you eat meat sacrificed to idols.
1 Korinćanima 8:7, ali nema svako razuma, jer neki koji još sad misle da su idoli nešto, kao idolske žrtve jedu.
Yeah, 1 Corinthians 8:7, the last part. And things offered unto idol, and their conscience being weak is defiled.
I savest njihova slaba, budući pogani se.
How is it, savest njihova?
Slaba.
Budući. Slaba, yeah, weak. You know, it means they get offended because you have faith.
Oni su pogođeni time zato što ti imaš veru.
You know? And they scream.
I oni možda vrište.
And they don't like it.
I ne sviđaju se.
And they have to grow in faith.
I moraju da rastu veru.
But also on the other hand,
a opet na drugoj strani,
then he says, well, then don't eat meat sacrificed to idols before them.
I onda kaže ovim drugim, nemojte jesti meso žrtvovano idolima pred tim ljudima.
Because they have to grow in faith first.
Jer oni treba da rastu ver.
And so on.
I tako dalje.
And we will finish with this word, 1 Kings chapter 3.
I završit ćemo sa ovim delom iz Biblije. Prva kraljevima, to jest...
there is a...
Prva kraljevima.
Yeah, chapter 3.
I kraljevima. Treći pogled.
And we can read in verses 24. 3:24.
Treći poglavlje 24.
There is a story about Solomon's wisdom, King Solomon's wisdom.
To je priča o mudrosti cara Solomona.
And there are two women harlots.
To su dve
prostitutes.
Dve prostitutke.
And they were sleeping together, and one of them laid over his child, and the child died.
Jedna je legla preko svog deteta i dete umrlo.
And they go before the king, two prostitutes with one child, and they have all, both of them say, the child is mine.
I one su izašle pred cara sa drugim detetom i rekle su, obe su rekle, to je moje dete.
And the king Solomon had the wisdom. Verse 24, he said, bring me a sword.
24. Stihu reče car, dajte mi mač.
And they brought the sword before the king.
Donesuše mač pred cara.
And the king said, divide the living child in two and give half to the one and half to the other.
Tada reče car, presecite živo dete na dvoje i podajte polovinu jednoj i polovinu drugoj.
You know, the word of God,
Božja reč,
Hebrews 4, the sword of the word of God,
Hebrejima 4, mač reči Božje,
it will cut and it will show the intents of our heart.
Ona će poseći i razdeliti, otkriti misli našeg srca.
Because here one of the women started to say,
jer ovde jedna žena počela da kaže, počela govoriti.
Verse 26, she said, oh my Lord, give her the living child and in no wise slay it.
Tada žena koji sin beše živi reče caru, jer se uskolebala utroba za sinom, ako gospodaru podajte njoj dete živo.
And the other said, let it be neither mine nor thine, but divide it, kill it.
A ona druga reče, neka ne bude ni meni ni tebi, rasecite ga.
You know, the church life,
znate, život u crkvi,
it's not about what's mine.
Nije šta, tu šta je moja.
This woman was able to give up the child that it would live.
Ona je bila sposobna da preda dete samo da bi ono živelo.
The word of God comes and cuts our heart.
Božja reč dolazi i seče naše srce.
And I can maybe give up my rights.
I ja možda mogu da prepustim neka prava koja imam.
That the person or the church can live.
Da bi druga osoba ili crkva mogla da živi.
As Paul says, I preach the cross, I die, that you may live.
Kao što je Paul rekao, ja propovedam krst, ja ću položiti svoj život da bi vi živeli.
In 2 Corinthians, I think chapter 5, we were teaching it. He says, death works in me, that life may work in you.
Mislim da u 2 Korinćanima 5 kaže, smrt vlada u nama da bi vama vladao život.
You know, we die that others may live.
Mi umiremo da bi drugi mogli da žive.
This is the cross, that's the love.
To je krst, to je ljubav.
Proverbs 27:17. I add two more verses and we end there.
Još dva stiha ću dodati u poslovicama.
Proverbs 27:17.
27:17.
It says that, I'll read it. 27:17. Iron sharpens iron, so man sharpens the countenance of his friend.
17. stih u 27. poglavlju. Gvožđe se gvožđem oštri, tako čovek oštri lice prijatelja svog.
You know, when you have two irons, iron sharpens iron.
Kada imate dva parčeta gvožđa, jedan drugi oštri.
You know, and then the sparks are flying.
Onda lete varnice.
It's like, put two people together.
Kao, da stavimo dva čoveka zajedno.
And after a while, you know,
inako
the sparks are flying.
Malo varnice.
They are sharpening one another.
Varnice lete.
Because he will say something.
Oni ostri jedno drugo, on će reći jedno.
And it revealed the evil content of my heart and I got angry.
I možda će otkriti zlu pomis samog srca, ja postanem besan.
Or maybe I love him beyond anything.
Ili ga možda volim preko svega toga.
You see, we are growing.
I mi rastemo.
You know, the bad things in the church are not so bad for us.
Loše stvari u crkvi nisu toliko loše za nas.
Because again, it's opportunity to reveal Christ.
Jer opet govorimo, to je prilika da pokažemo Krista.
It's opportunity to love somebody.
To je prilika da volimo neko.
And Isaiah 54:2.
I Isaija 54. poglavlje, drugi stih.
God speaks to nation Israel.
Bog govori državi Izrael, naciji Izrael.
And he speaks about their capacity.
I govori o njihovom kapacitetu, mogućnosti.
And he says, enlarge the place of your tent.
Kaže, raširi mesto šatora svojega.
And let them stretch forth the curtains of your habitations.
I zavese stana tvojega, neka se razastru.
Spare not.
Ne brani.
Lengthen your cords and strengthen your stakes.
Produži užad svoja i kolje svoje utvrdi.
You know, embrace everybody.
Šta to znači? Prihvati sve.
He says, don't be just for yourself.
Ne budi samo za sebe.
He says here, spare not.
I on kaže ne brani.
Don't enlarge just a little bit and say that's enough.
Nemoj samo malo da proširiš i kažeš to je dosta.
Anybody is welcome.
Svi su dobrodošli.
And God can do work in their life.
I Bog može da radi.
And here in the context, when you read verse 3, it speaks about the Gentiles.
I kada čitamo u kontekstu, Bog govori u trećem stihu, to je o neznabošcima, to jest nejevrejima.
He's revealing to them that they can enlarge the tent and accept the Gentiles.
On otkriva Izraelu da mogu da prošire svoje šatore i da prihvate neznabošce i nejevreje.
You know, the Gentiles worship paganism and many gods.
Nejevreje, neznabošce koji se klanjaju idolima i koji su mnogo bošci.
And they do human sacrifices.
I koji čine, prinose ljudske žrtve.
And they do not keep monogamy.
I nisu monogami.
You know, and other things.
I ostale stvari.
And he says, these people.
I on kaže, ti
ljudi. These horrible people.
Ti užasni ljudi.
Bring them in.
Dovedi.
Love them.
Voli.
You know, show them Christ.
Evo, pokaži mi.
Lay down your life.
Položi svoj život.
As Apostle Paul in Corinth.
Kao apostol Pavel u Korintu.
That's the perfect church.
To je savršena crkva.
Not the perfect church, like
ne kao savršena crkva.
In this sense,
u ovom smislu,
and no love,
bez ljubavi.
Sterile, no life.
Sve sterilno, bez života.
Or it's a church which is like moving.
Ili je crkva koja se pomera.
You know, this guy and this woman and this guy. And...
Jo, ovaj čovjek, ova žena, ovaj čovjek.
Yeah, but I am happy he is here.
Ja sam srećen da je on tu.
Because we can love him.
Jer možemo da ga volimo.
And you know, he loves us too, that's why he's coming.
I on voli nas, zato i dolazi.
Because he sees the love of God.
Zato što vidi Božju ljubav.
That's a perfect church.
I to je savršena crkva.
You know, the perfect church which has the love of God.
Savršena crkva koja ima Božju ljubav.
And that's what we are.
I to je ono ko smo mi.
And I just wanted to say it because I've heard so many things.
Ja opet želim da kažem, sam čuo mnogo stvari.
You know, even about our church.
Čak i o našoj crkvi.
But I'm so proud about you.
Ali ja se ponosim vama.
You know, you are accepting everybody, loving everybody.
Prihvatate sve, volite sve.
And we have authority.
I mi imamo autoritet.
Over the word of God.
Božje reči.
Which is teaching us and changing us.
Koja nas uči, koja nas menja.
You know, we have a very strong anointing in preaching.
Imamo veliko pomazanje, jako pomazanje u propovedanju.
And it changes us.
I ono nas menja.
God is not leaving us the old.
Bog nas ne ostavlja da budemo stari.
He's showing us that we are new.
On nam pokazuje da smo novi.
You know, whoever is in Christ, he is a new creation.
Ko god je u Hristu, on je novo stvorenje.
2 Corinthians 5:17, right? We will be there soon.
2 Corinthians 5:17, bit ćemo tu.
In the Bible school.
U biblijskoj školi.
And this is what Paul says to this horrible church in Corinth.
I to Pavle govori o ovoj užasnoj crkvi u Korintu.
Yeah. He is teaching them by showing them that they are new in Christ.
On ih uči time što im pokazuje da su novo stvorenje u Hristu.
So again, thank you Jesus for this church.
Molim se. Hvala ti Isuse za ovu crkvu.
Thank you Jesus for these people, precious people.
Hvala ti Gospode za ove ljude divne.
For every one of us.
Za sve nas.
Oh, you brought us together.
Ti si nas okupio.
You are doing something so amazing.
Ti činiš nešto nevjerovatno.
You know, this is perfect work of God.
I ovo je savršeno delo Božje.
Yeah, these little details like
I sve sa tim malim detaljima.
Who cares?
Koga briga?
This is the work of God.
Ovo je Božje delo.
And we are so blessed you called us into this.
Mi smo se tako blagosloveni da si nas pozvao.
You know, change us.
Promeni nas.
Use us.
Iskoristi nas.
You know, thank you are using us.
Hvala ti što nas koristiš, Gospod.
You know, and use us greatly in the Balkans and...
Koristi nas dosta na Balkan.
And for Serbia.
Za Srbiju.
In Jesus' name we pray.
U Isusu ime se molim.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. And do we have a song for the end?